johnford.radio.
What a car, what a price, what a dealer, wasn't he nice?
Now,
for a brand new Ford or a fine used car, here is the dealer, take our advice.
It's the Evening Rancor, the daily podcast from that guy who talks about stuff, John Ford. Any links mentioned on the show are available at johnford.radio. Today, we're coming to you direct from your mom's basement. Welcome to the Evening Rancor, the John Ford podcast.
I know. I've really fallen down on the job with these podcasts. And, you know, I promised at least a couple of weeks, and it's only been 1 week. Just spank me, would you?
Let me whack her, man. Let's do it.
Yesterday, I went to the grocery store. I know it's not the thing to do 2 days before Thanksgiving.
No.
I'm always telling people how great people are here in Austin, Texas. How they're nice and friendly and how you can talk to them and they're not mean and nasty like they are in other places that I've lived. Hint, hint, Florida and New York City.
He's nice, bit of a close talker.
Although people in New York are not really nasty. They're just in a hurry. People in Florida, nasty. Boy. And I can say that as a Floridian. That's where I was raised, man. Southeast Florida, the other borough of New York. People there are just generally nasty.
Oh, please.
Want a bad experience? Go to Publix any day of the week. Although Publix is a great grocery store. The people that go there, maybe not so much. Yesterday, I did the offensive thing of going to the grocery store 2 days before Thanksgiving just to pick up a couple of incidentals that I needed, along the way so that I could base my bird and also cook my turkey. I'd go further by talking about basing my bird, but current laws and regulations prohibit me from doing so. Anyway, I was noticing when I was in the grocery store, man, people were mean like they were from Florida there. Wow, it was crazy. These normally nice Texas people in Austin were banging into me with shopping carts, not even saying excuse me, and it was just like total mayhem. So my advice to you, even if you are in a friendly place like Austin, Texas, avoid the grocery store, for the next month. Avoid any stores for the next month. People wonder why Amazon does so well. Yeah, it's because you don't have to go to the store and deal with idiots and morons and mean people. Have you heard about the E. coli romaine lettuce scare? It's the big news. It's a big news on all the news channels today, the day before Thanksgiving. I guess one person has at least died, but a bunch of people are sick from E. coli from romaine lettuce. This seems to happen every once in a while, although this one does look pretty bad. It's so bad, they're saying if you have any romaine lettuce in your refrigerator, if you have bought romaine lettuce any time in your lifetime and it's still in your refrigerator. Personally, I have one of those like things where you suck the air out of it and seal it. So I got some romaine that I bought a couple weeks ago, which is still fine because it's been sucked. I could talk more about sucking my lettuce, but current laws and regulations prohibit me from doing so.
Uh-oh.
Anyways, if you eat this romaine lettuce, you could die. All the outbreaks look like it's happening up in the upper Midwest and the Northeast. Does this mean in Texas I'm okay?
No.
On CNN today, I'm watching and they're talking about, they love stuff that scares people on CNN. It's the scariest thing ever. It's, sensational news. But they do the same thing on Fox, which is why I don't watch mostly American news channels. I watch France 24. I watch Al Jazeera, believe it or not. Deutschwelle, which is the German one. And what's the other one I watch? Oh, right, Sky News out of England and BBC. Because so much of the news that they cover on, not to get sidetracked, but so much of the news that they cover on CNN and Fox is just, it's like 80% of it is politics. There's more happening in the news than politics. And when it's not politics, it's scaremongering, which is what this E. coli thing is. And the woman on, the brilliant, genius talking head on CNN says, "Well, Mr. Expert, what is it that's causing this?" Well, for one thing, you don't cook lettuce, so if there's contaminants on it, even if you washed it, you could still get sick. And where does E. coli come from? Well, I'm no, microbiologist, but from what I understand, it's basically from poop. You get sick from poop on your lettuce. It seems to me the last time they tracked a lot of this stuff down, it was coming from farms, a lot of them in Mexico, that were spraying poop water. Can I say poop?
No.
I said poop. I said poop. We're spraying poop water on the lettuce. Man, I tell you, I don't want my lettuce with no poop water on it.
Not a good idea.
So the advice they give you from CNN and all the other scaremongers is stay away from romaine lettuce. Stick with stuffing that bird, okay? Stick with rutabaga. I love rutabaga for Thanksgiving. It's one of those things I dig. And, you know, maybe, you know, if you're not white, you shouldn't celebrate Thanksgiving anyways, because that would be cultural appropriation. Well, I hate to say it, but that's all the time I've got for the Evening Rancor. I almost said the Evening Wanker.
I don't get it.
Actually, that's kind of a good name. That's all the time I've got today for the Evening Rancor, the John Ford podcast. I've just got so much to do, as I'm sure you do too, in preparation for Thanksgiving. Gotta go stuff that bird and wash my poop lettuce and take care of all the important things. But I do thank you for checking in today and listening to the John Ford podcast, the Evening Rancor. Before I go, I just want to say one thing. It popped up in my little pop-up bubble on my computer, you know, where it gives you dates and birthdays, and it tells you different things. Some things you want to know, some other things you can give a damn about. But it said that my friend, who passed away last year, my friend M. Dung, Mike Slavko, would have been his birthday on Thanksgiving. So, Mr. Dung, it all kind of fits in with the poop lettuce, doesn't it? Wherever you are, I hope you're stuffing that turkey.
This program is for re-educational purposes only. Resemblance to real persons, living or dead, is probably intentional. Contents under pressure, use only as directed, some assembly required. Void where inhibited, batteries not included, use only as directed. If confusion persists, consult your physician. Driver does not carry cash, this disclaimer is subject to change without notice.